Folks, today we will talk about coaching. A very important question is why coaching is required. We will discuss in detail about coaching, skill set for the coach, who is coaching, what impact coaching is doing in the career path of the coachee, and how the industry is getting benefits. With these four or five questions we will complete in this video. Number one, what is coaching? Coaching is a process to achieve the peak performance or maximize the performance of coach. It focuses on the goals. It uses the 100% potential of an employee or coachee. It is a continual learning process. Coaching helps in development or progress of industry as well as the human being or any individual. Coaching support to the learner to achieve the desired results in scheduled time. Coaching process address the concern of an individual that hinders them to do excel. So these four or five things we are achieving during the course coaching process. I am giving the two important definitions of coaching, which you can use for your benefit in future life. Number one definition is, the coaching is a process that aims to improve performance and focuses on the here and now, not in future. Here and now, rather than on the distance past or future. Coaching is unlocking a person's potential, unleashing the person's potential to maximize their own performance. It helps, or it is helping them to learn rather than teaching to them. So by coaching, we are helping the learners to achieve the desired results in this scheduled time. The second definition is, coaching is a form of development in which a person called a coach supports a learner or client in achieving a specific personal or professional goal by providing training and guidance. It is the way of unleashing someone's potential in order to improve performance. It is addressing the concern of a person that hinders them to excel. So these two definitions are very common definition for coaching in industry. Coaching is a very popular word. We are listening this word from our student life to this date. When somebody is talking about career, the people are talking about coaching. So in this video, I am talking about the coaching processes in professional organizations to achieve the peak performance of coachee or unleash the 100% potential to do or to maximize his or her potential. Number second thing we were talking about, what are the coaching skills? This is a very important method or tool. Many people are doing coaching process for various types of coaching process or for various kind of their client or customers. Here we are talking about only the industrial or organizational coaching process and what are the key skills are required in this process, we are focusing on that only. We are not focusing on students' coaching. We are not talking about the sports coaching. We are not talking about some other processes of coaching, only talking about the coaching in the organization for the benefit of the organization as well as benefit of the young executive or employee. What are those skills? There are many skills. They are a set of coaching skills that every good coach possesses. What makes a good coach? What are the qualities? What are the number of essential coaching skills you need to become a great coach? We have to understand. Number one, goal setting. It is a skill how to set the goal. Number two is methods or tools. What kind of methodology we have to use to coach the coachee? Number three, evaluate. How to evaluate, when to evaluate, to whom we have to evaluate, where we have to evaluate. We have to understand these things in a complete day program. But here we are summarizing these skills. Next is the regular check-ins. When we are doing this process, we have to do the regular check-in process. We have to ask questions. Asking question is a best methodology in coaching. What kind of questions we have to ask, we will discuss in detail later. Next is that get feedback and give feedback. Feedback is also very important factor of coaching. So two things are very important in this coaching process. Number one, how we are asking the question, whether we are asking open-ended question, or we are asking closed-ended question, or we are asking the question for discussion, or we are asking the question for some other way. There are many methods we will discuss in detail some other video. The same thing, what kind of feedback we are giving, to whom we are giving, when we are giving, who is the right person, we will discuss in detail. Second, next is, provide structure. We have to provide the support to the coachee so that he or she can use his or her potential 100%. Be curious. We have to understand these processes, what we have to do, where we have to do. Again and again, we are saying these things, but these things are very important. Number three, rapport, empathy. The rapport with the coachee of the coach should be very, very highly emotional and effective. When we are emotional with the coachee, then he will believe. Coaching process is the depend on the trust of each other. When we are having trust, we are believing in ourselves or we are believing in coach, then we can use this process. If we are not believing in ourselves or we are not believing in coach, then this process will not help at all. So rapport building or empathetical rapport building is very important factor of coaching skill. Next is observatory skill. Look and observe what is happening, where is the gap, where we can provide support, what kind of questions we can ask so that the coachee can understand the real meaning. Next is the active listening. The coach should be the sounding board. When coachee is saying anything, the coach must listen carefully and patiently. These two things are very important in this coaching process. When coachee is talking, coachee is speaking, coachee is saying something, coachee is doing something, when we have to observe and we have to listen very carefully, patiently. And then we have to give feedback. So these are the important skills for a very good coach, or these are the qualities when one coach must possess. Next thing we will talk about, how to make it more effective. How can we make this coaching process, coach and coachee relationship, more effective or more beneficial to both? Number one, decide what you want to accomplish. This should be very clear from day one. Because coaching process starts with the what you have to achieve in the end of process. So that should be in the mind of both. So we have to decide. This is called goal setting process. Second thing, choose the right path. We are not supposed to divert. We are not supposed to do mistakes. We are not supposed to indulge ourselves in those activities which are not required at all. So we have to be very straightforward, and we have to be on the right path, on right schedule, and in right direction. Number three is stay on top of the process. When we are doing this coaching process, always it should be in your priority, and you have to keep this process always on top. Forget all other things. When you are talking about this process, when you want to develop something in your life, then you have to focus. It means your focus should be on your goal. Until unless you are not 100% focused on your goal or about your goal, you cannot achieve, you cannot accomplish them. Number four is give feedback. Who can give the right feedback? There are some qualities. How to give feedback? I am giving some examples here. Number one, don't be vague, be specific. Your feedback should be very clear, concise, and specific with an example. Number two, provide examples. Examples when, where, and what mistake or what good thing you have done. So what is important? When, where, and what. In feedback, this should be very clear. If somebody is not giving example, somebody is not talking clearly and giving the vague statement, that is not feedback. That is something else. Number three is tell them what was not done right. Be specific. What kind of mistakes or what wrong action you have done, you have to tell very specifically, and a coach has to tell the coachee very specifically. Number four is show how it should be done differently. So you have to suggest two, three things. Can we do in this way? You can think in this direction, or you can cover this, or you have to remove this, you have to leave this, you have to focus this, you can focus on this. The can is very important word, because can is unleashing your potential. Number fifth is explain why it should be done in a certain way. You tell, or a coach must tell to the coach, why it should be done in that particular way or in certain way. What will be the benefit? What you can get? When you can get? It should be very clear in this process. Number five is how to make it more effective. Process number five is review and recalibrate yourself. you review. Plan, do, check, act is a very good tool for this coaching process. Plan, do, check, act. Plan, do, check, act. So you have to review what we want to do, what we have done, where we have achieved, where we have not achieved, what mistakes we have done in the past, where we have to take care, we have to take different path, where we have to be very careful, and we have to recalibrate our process. If one process fails, one plan fails, then you have to keep your alternate plan ready so that you can start to work immediately. Actually, success is starts from the recalibration process. When you are recalibrating yourself or your processes, then you can get success very easily. If you are not recalibrating yourself or you are not recalibrating your process, after failure, you may be frustrated. So in this coaching process, review and recalibration is a very important and effective tool. So these are the things where a coach can help to the coach. Number next, we have to understand the difference of you do and you can do. If somebody is giving this word you do, it means he or she is ordering. He or she is not behaving as a coach. If somebody is talking you can do, it means they are talking as a coach. They are talking as an effective leader. So can is unleashing your potential like anything. By using the word can, you can develop your efficiency bar every day. So can is a very important word of coaching process, and we must use in our life. What is happening? People either using directly to do or should do. Should is a political word. Should is not a word for the common man. If somebody is using should, it means he or she is not taking any responsibility or accountability. If somebody is using can, that means he or she want to help you in a literal meaning. So we have to understand this difference in this process. Next word is 5 important factors to creating a successful coaching. What kind of factors we have to keep in mind? We are talking only 5. There are many factors, but here we are talking only 5 important factors. Number 1, align coaching with your company's core values, because every organization has core values. It can be different to every organization. Some may common, some may different. I have worked so many organizations, every time I have faced the different kind of value set. In one organization, commitment, integrity, passion, speed was the core values. In other organization, respect, commitment, your personal growth, such kind of value systems. Some people are having different kind set of values. So we have to deal with the company's core values. Our actions should connect with company's core values. Number 2, understand what motivates your employee. This is very, very important. What motivational process can help your employees to achieve higher? I'm not talking about monetary motivations. I am talking about non-monetary motivations. A satisfied employee can be an engaged employee. But a satisfied employee sometimes may not be a engaged employee. Vice versa, engaged employees are always satisfied employees. Always, there is no doubt. But your satisfied employee can be a engaged employee or may not be. Because satisfaction may come in many things. I can quote one example. One person is coming in time in the office, going to the home in time, and he is getting good salary. He is not doing anything. He is satisfied. But he is not engaged or she is not engaged. So you have to understand the difference between satisfaction and engagement. So in this process, we have to check the level of engagement. Satisfaction is not our issue. Our issue is whether we are engaging our employees 100% or 90% or not. Number three, keep it collaborative. Whether our processes are collaborating with every employee or not. If not collaborating, then you have to recheck or recalibrate. That is why review and recalibration is required. Number four is know your team dynamics. The coach has to understand the dynamics of team, many dynamics. You can think their value system. You can think their skill set. You can think about or you can talk about their genders. You can talk about their level of education, their working style. So many dynamics you have to understand. What are the family background? What are their value system? Because individual has its own value system. So you have to understand these dynamics. The number fifth, that is also very important, the coaching is an art as science, as much as art as science. This is a very important, because coaching process is connecting with the employee with emotions. When you are empathetically connecting your emotions with the coach, then you can achieve any damn thing. When you are talking logically, then you are using the science in your relations. But logics are not always helpful. But empathetical connection or empathetic feelings approach are always good in coaching process. So it is very important you have to use this process as art or you have to use this process as science. It's your skill and your ability where you have to use what. Number next is, why are employees not interested in this process? Because in India, the coaching process is not familiar. Some progressive employers are using this organization. My organization, VK Dynamic Leadership Center, is providing this support to one or two clients. But we are always discussing with many employers to use this process, to take the benefit of this process, because this is very important process. So we have to discuss here why employees are not interested in this process. What is happening in the organizations? How the employer can take lead? Number one, where the motivation is lacking. Lack of motivation is the main issue. When your employees are not motivated, or you are motivating employee with monetary scheme only, then this will not work. Number two, lack of knowledge. Your employees are not having any knowledge about this process. So you have to do some publicity. Employer has to do some work so that people can understand the importance, or they can develop some awareness about the coaching process, and they can choose, because this process is useful to them also. Their career path will move like anything. When you will unleash their potential, they will grow. Sometimes employer is not using the 100% potential of their employees. So this is a very important factor. Number three factor is lack of trust. This is very important. When employee do not have trust in his employer or the management team, then they will not come out. Because some managers, organizations are not doing anything, but managers are doing. Some top team is doing. And if they are playing with the emotions of the employee, or they are have some ulterior motives, then you will lose your credibility, or you will have the lack of trust in their mind. So these three things are very important when you are going to use this process in any organization. And we have to be very careful before starting this. Otherwise, it will not work as you designed. How to overcome with these barriers? There are four or five processes. We have to focus on that. I am talking about only four major processes. There are a number of processes, but here I am talking about four major processes which are very important and essential for any organization. Number one, develop trust among your team members. This is the first requirement. The trust level should be very high. Number two, share company goal. Your goal should be shared to every individual of the organization, whosoever is coming inside the organization, irrespective of hierarchy level or irrespective of his or her designation. Everybody should be aligned with the company goal, what company want to achieve during this financial year, or what is the bigger goal of the company after 5 years or 10 years, what they want to be, how to develop their brand image. So communication and sharing of company goal is a very important aspect. People are talking about, one term is very popular, performance highway. Performance highway only works in those organizations where everybody is connecting to the performance highway. Because when the director is talking or employer is talking, then directors are talking, then senior level executives are talking, then actually functional heads are talking, then departmental heads are connecting, then sectional heads are connecting, then subsectional are connecting, then show floor team is connecting. Then show floor team means every individual, even the contractual worker is connecting. That is called performance highway system. Everybody is doing in the same direction. That this flow will make very easy this process. To share the company goal in time and to everybody. Number three, determine motivation. How you will check what is the level of motivation? I am giving some set of questions. You may ask, it depend on your circumstances. You may ask the open-ended question or you may ask the closed-ended question also. What are those questions? Do you need more information about your role? Because role clarity is very important. What we have to do? What is my accountability? What is my responsibility? What is my freedom to act? This kind of things very specific in your job profile or in your job description. Number two is, do you need continuing education or further training? Because in India, some of the employers are treating training as an expense. They are not treating the training process as an investment. They are not calculating ROI, return on investment. So we have to develop that kind of culture in the organization. The people can ask openly, yes, I want training, or I want further education in this regard. Number three, Are they any resource? Are they require any resource? If you want to engage 100%, then you have to focus on these things: equipment, tools, methodology, work environment, structure, their welfare. These things we have to bother. So are there any resource that I need to get you? Next question is, what do you think you're stalling out? So these kind of open-ended or closed-ended questions, I'm giving this line again and again. It depends on circumstances. But in this coaching process, open-ended questions are always better. Minimize your closed-ended questions. Closed-ended questions where you have to take direct feedback. Number four process is coach and cultivate the relationship. The relationship among all employees and with the management should be very cohesive. There should be a very good work culture. There should be a very good environment to work. Then you can break these barriers and you can grow your organization like anything. So we have to discuss and we have to use this process after breaking these barriers. What are the benefits of coaching process in any organization? Number one benefit, empowers individuals and encourage them to take responsibility. Number two, increase employees and staff engagement. Number three, improve individual performance or achieve the peak performance. Number four is help identify and develop high potential employees. When you will talk about the performance and potential, then you can identify the future leaders who is doing very high performance and having high potential to grow. Focus on those employees. Don't focus on those employees which are having low potential and low performance. Forget them. So you have to check. So you have to identify those who are having very high performance, who are performing well, and also having the high potential to grow. Number fifth is help identify both organization and digital strength and development opportunities. How you can use those skills or use those employees' skills. Number six, help to motivate and empower individual to do excel. This is very important. In some organization, this coaching process is being used when they are promoting some employee from one level to the higher level. When somebody is promoting assistant manager to deputy manager, then they are doing the coaching process. Because that time, he or she has to adopt some new competence and he has or she has to do something extra. They have to learn something new. When they are recruiting the employees from the campuses, they are doing this coaching skill because they want to develop a different kind of culture. So coaching helps in many ways. So the benefit of the coaching process is tremendous. Whosoever is using effectively, they are enjoying like anything. Number six benefit is help to motivate and empower the individual to excel. Number seven is demonstrate organizational commitment to human resource development. It is only be effective when the senior team is demonstrating the organizational commitment to the human resource development. Because human capital is very important capital. in any condition, your human capital will work and they will support you if you are demonstrating the organizational commitment in an effective manner. Your human capital can change your work condition in a better condition. They can be the game changer in any adverse condition. The people are talking about VUCA word, but your human capital change this VUCA word in a opportunity, and you can grow like anything. So we have to understand these kind of benefits, and we have to be very effective use this kind of skill set, and we have to coach our employees in a right direction, in a right way, or with the right team also. Because so many players playing in the market, so we have to be very careful. Number next is, we have to talk about what is very important, how the people can enjoy this process when we are talking about these things. Today, we will talk only this much. Sometime, we will make another video and we will talk in detail. Till then, goodbye. Enjoy this video. Try to understand this process and enjoy the benefit of this process and grow your employees, grow your organization, help to develop the nation.